Close the hand. Praise the Lord. Amen. You know, even when we think about the church and the spirit, the spiritual church, amen, how we see things around us, amen. And for years we preached against it. Don't have nothing to do with that. Don't let that come in here. Amen. And now all of a sudden we take a second look at it. We entertain the thought of having it in here too. Amen. And then all of a sudden that desire kicks in. And we as a people, we want it. Amen. Just like the children of Israel, they wanted a king. Everybody around us got a king. How come we can't have one? I mean, skip the invisible king. Amen. Because that was one that was coming down through the ages. Amen. And he would be the king of kings and the lord of lords. Amen. The desire had kicked in. The lust of the flesh. And then the last thing was the pride of life. Says she took of the fruit thereof and did eat, and gave also to her husband, and he did eat. Pride, you know pride ain't be in here. Because the Bible tells us, lets us know that pride comes before the great fall. Amen. Pride comes. You might not be able to identify ready right off the bat. Amen. But once you study that thing and examine it, you will find that pride, amen, was there before that division. Amen. Praise God. This is one of the things that I wrestled with that God dropped in my spirit. I wrestled with it because I just didn't understand it. When he first shared this thought with me. In the world, a division travels from the bottom to the top. In the world, a division travels, a split now, travels from the bottom to the top. In the spiritual world, division travels from the top to the bottom. In the spiritual world. Now that's something you will just have to pray about. Digest it, because I say I really struggle with it. And this is indicated by the rending of the veil in the temple. Praise God. When God deals with us, he deals with us from the head down to the bottom. That's why the scripture plainly says that judgment is going to begin at the house of God. Judgment is going to begin at the house of God because it's going to start at the top and go down to the bottom. Amen. Jesus has always been our example. If he says anything, it's because he practices it himself. Amen. And I thought about heaven. Now, God tells us to be holy. To be holy. And how we have to clean. Amen. How we have to purge. And do, praise God. And he practiced that in heaven. Amen. When Lucifer and those angels rose up, didn't God handle things? Didn't he handle things? Amen. He handled it from the top. And it's working its way down to the bottom. what God has done in the heavens, he's going to do in the earth. Amen. He's going to do in the earth. Amen. So once again, in the world, division travels from the bottom to the top. Amen. If you want to build it to fall, then you got to tamper with its foundation. Amen. You pull some of the foundation from underneath it and watch it come tumbling down. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Just to reiterate how God deals with us from the top to the bottom, you remember, praise God, Psalm 133. Amen. Which talked about the whole, how good and pleasant it is for the brethren. Amen. For we as brothers and sisters dwell together in unity. Amen. And it goes on to say that it's like, amen, an anointing. Mm-hmm. That flows down. Now that anointing was flowing from the top to the bottom. Amen. The anointing from Aaron's head ran down his beard right on down to the hem of his garment. Amen. Once again, to let you know that when God deals with us, he's going to deal with us from the top to the bottom.